I know, right? And with the thing. Oh, welcome back to the program. You, of course, are watching the Later Than Not show, and I am your host, Donald Letterhead. Let's get right back to it, shall we? We're about to welcome to the studio one of our most one of our regular guests. He is the Comptroller General of the Detroit Zoological Society and one of the world's most foremost activists for conservation. He's a serious pain to deal with. Will you please welcome back to the studio, Dr. Jungle Joe Handy. Welcome back, Joe.
Thank you, Donald. It's always a pleasure to be here.
Yeah. My producers say that I should say the same to you. Well, the sooner we get this started, the sooner you'll be out of here, so why don't you bring out the menagerie, huh, shall we?
All right. Okay. Well, I thought we'd start off small, so this little guy that we're going to bring out to the stage here, he's actually a North American common squirrel.
Oh, well, Joe, this is a nice change of pace for you. A cute, cuddly little domestic animal.
See, that's right, Donald. This is the North American common squirrel. As the winter months start to really encroach on us up here, they're gonna start to look for food wherever they can. Sometimes they'll even be so bold as to take it away from humans.
Joe, it took my coffee. Do squirrels even drink coffee, Joe?
Now, this is a little fact that I don't think most people know. See, the common Central American squirrel is one of the largest producers of French roast coffee in the world.
I don't actually think that that is true. Could we get a fact check? Fact check, please? And you, give me that.
Ow!
All right, Joe, well, come on, let's just keep this televised tragedy going, shall we? What is your next animal?
Oh, well, this fluffy little guy might be a little more up your alley.
Oh, now here we go. Is this what I think it is? You see, it's a bunny!
Very good, Donald. It is a bunny rabbit, but it's not just
your... He's so cute. Can I touch him? I want to pet the rabbit. Joe, I'm gonna pet the rabbit.
Donald, I don't think that's really a very good or wise idea. You see, this is a Transylvanian rabbit. It feeds mostly on meat and, well, blood. I thought it would be interesting to bring to the show. You know, it's a great opportunity to talk about current events. For example, Edward or Jacob?
No, we are not going to talk about Twilight! Not after your rabbit bit me! Gah!
Well, okay, alright. The next animal, you see...
No, Joe, not the next animal! Your last animal nearly took a finger off!
I thought I'd bring something you might be able to handle a little bit better, Donald. This little guy.
Whoa! Little guy? That's a bull, Joe! That is a bull!
Correct again, Donald. Good job. What is that? Two in a row for you? Now, this particular bull is named Ferdinand, and, well, he knows a little trick he'd like to share with you. Here we go. We'll just use this. If you would just hold on to this for me.
Oh, no. I know what this is about. Now, you're just trying to get me killed.
Donald, I don't think you should wave that around quite like
this
that.
This is my show, and you are going to listen to me. Now, come on. That is it! Will someone please fire the person that booked this mental patient? Holy! That is a elephant, Joe! How did you even get an elephant into the studio?
Donald, this is the happiest little guy.
Joe, I think you and I have a different idea of what the word little means, Joe. Now get that thing out of here!
Calm down, Donald. You don't want to get Jumbo here all riled up.
And the bull isn't going to do that? What is that animal still doing in the studio?
Well, you see, this little lady here is named Philippa.
What the? Joe, is that a falcon? Shouldn't you get the elephant out of here before you bring in a falcon?
Actually, the falcon is nature's only defense against a rampaging elephant, and, well, the way that you're flailing about, I thought it would be a good idea.
A better idea might just be to put the animals away, Joe. How about you put the animals away?
Oh, but then of course the falcon might just get distracted by the squirrel.
Where did he go?
Joe. Joe, put the animals away. And so goes my first foray into hosting a late night television show. Or I guess if you watch the video before breakfast, it could be a morning show. All of that, of course, was a tribute to the segments between David Letterman and Jungle Jack Hanna. Some of the most fun, funny, iconic television were the episodes between those two. Hand shadows, though, are a lot of fun. I actually had more fun with these than some of the other skills that I've tried so far. And most of what I did you can pick up in a couple of minutes. It's animating them and bringing them to life that takes a lot of work. Plenty of videos floating around YouTube if you'd like to get started doing some of these. And if you get really into it, I'm sure your local library is going to have a copy or two of some books in this series by Henry Bursill. You know, there's some people out there doing really incredible hand shadow performances, including an amazing scene in Cirque du Soleil's Las Vegas production, Ka. Of course, who could forget groups like Palabolas and their shadow work? Some really exciting stuff using whole troops of dancers to create these elaborate shadow sculptures. So you know the drill. Click subscribe to follow along with the Useless Skill Challenge, or go to Facebook and search for The Aji Show to find out more about me, my juggling shows, and where you can see some useless skills live in person at a theater near you. So tune in next time. I betcha won't want to miss it.